You want that same song?
Yeah.
And as the pace of life gets faster and faster,
phones down in five,
and attention spans get shorter and shorter, you're probably not going to just
Spider-Man and freezing, full effect. You ready, Ron? I'm ready.
You ready, dude?
I'm ready, slick, are you?
Oh, yeah. Ready,
girl. Girl, I must warn you.
I had a lot of good feedback from a lot of y'all. People was inboxing me and everything, like, and it was even people that I didn't even know. I'm like, wow, this is love. But somebody was like, bitch, is you still alive? Like, yes, I'm still alive. I'm sorry I made y'all wait so long. I was in a lot of pain. That shit was excruciating pain. Like, that shit hurted. So this video is for everyone. Oh, so, you know, I just wanted to let y'all know that I do appreciate y'all. And to subscribe to my new channel, because I'm going to be posting makeup videos and tutorials and a bunch of bullshit. Yeah, hair, whatever, just a bunch of bullshit. About, they like, it ain't bullshit. Bullshit. It's like, no. A bunch of real shit. Or whatever. So just make sure y'all subscribe to my channel. But this video was for anyone that always wanted to get their breasts done, but they just wasn't sure, or they was scared, or maybe they thought the price was too high, especially if they're in Philadelphia, because Philadelphia is high as shit. I'm from Philly. Hey. Anyway, Philly baby. But fuck Philly, because y'all high as shit. Sorry, Billy. So I'm just gonna share just some brief information about why I always wanted my breasts done, why they decided to get them joints for me, just like that. Cause he the shit. He's awesome. And what else? How much they cost? I wrote a few things down. Information that I would think that y'all probably would want to know. My trip to Miami from Philly, the place I stayed in and why I picked the place I stayed in, my pre-op, day of surgery, and post-op. This video gonna be fast because the bitch ain't got a lot of memory on the phone, you know what I'm saying? So, so the reason why I always wanted breasts is because everybody in my family has breasts on both sides, which isn't fair. except for me. And I remember when I was like 12 years old. So I have a sister. I have one sister. She's like 4 years older than me. And she's my size. I'm 108 pounds. 18 to 110 pounds. And I'm 5'4". My sister is probably like 5'2". Around the same size. And she always had like D cups, big beautiful breasts. My other sister that's 1 year older than me and her, like when we were 12 years old, my breast was bigger than hers. And I used to always be like, aha, my breast is bigger than yours. Bitch, that bitch turned 14. Them joints was like, boom. She went over the C cups. I'm like, nigga. But it's cool because I'm 13 now and I'll turn 14 next year. And them joints definitely gonna be popping. I'll wait my turn.
I know I'm different.
Okay. Yes. 14 came, nothing. I'm like, what the fuck? 16 came, nothing. Negative. Motherfucking 18 came. I'm in the fucking library. Google. When I was 18. Yeah, I was in a library. I remember I was looking up some shit. Like, when is the last... Like, when do your breasts ever stop growing? I was even asking my doctors and everything. And they said, like, early, your breasts can still grow all the way up to, like, in your early 20s. So I'm like, all right, cool. 21 came. Negative. I'm like, what the fuck? I had a baby. Mind you, I'm 28 now. I had a baby when I got pregnant at 26. So, and everybody was like, oh, when you have a baby, your breast is going to get big. This and the third, all them is going to be popping. And yes, they did. They grew when that fucking milk was in there. Them drones was popping. And no, all right, no, I'm sorry. Let me rewind back. Before I got pregnant, I was about to, I put money down on a boob job. I put down $1,000. Then I got pregnant and I just completely forgot all about it. Yeah. They wound up keeping that shit.
You told you couldn't do it while you're pregnant.
Yeah, I can't. You can't get your breast done while you're pregnant anyway. And but I forgot all about it until it was too late. So then I wound up getting pregnant. I breastfed for like 14 months. Then I wanted to get my breast done again.
Because
oh my god, when I was pregnant and that milk was in there, them joints was so beautiful. I remember being stingy and shit with the nipple. I was like, oh my god, babe, oh my god, this is what I look like with boobs. Once I realized what I looked like with boobs, it was a wrap. I was getting them done no matter what. It was a wrap. Fuck that. I'm going inside my motherfucking saving. It's like, no, I'm playing. Picking pennies and shit out the couch. No, but it was a wrap. I was like, damn, I look good as shit. Oh my god. And then I wound up getting pregnant again. And I wound up having a miscarriage. Well, once I wound up getting pregnant again, I couldn't get my breast done. And then I wound up having a miscarriage. I'm not even gonna elaborate on that. It was horrible. But in the day of the day that I came home from the miscarriage, all right, so you know how people they look, like people be having addictions of looking at certain things on YouTube or whatever. Some people like to listen to music or makeup tutorials or whatever. I've always, since I've discovered YouTube or the internet, period, I've always had an obsession of looking at boobs. I love titties. If you're my friend and you got titties, I'm looking at them titties. Even if you're not my friend, like, I'm so obsessed with titties, you would think I'm fucking gay. Like, I love the shit out of titties. But not because I'm gay, but because I'm just so obsessed with the thought of having titties. You know how, like, females will look at another girl ass, but not because we're gay, but because, damn, I wish I had that ass. You know what I mean? So it's kind of like that. So, yeah. Oh, so the day of my surgery or whatever, well, when I came back from my miscarriage, I'm, you know, doing my huge, looking at titties and people pre-ops and post-ops and, you know, different experiences or whatever they have and surgeries. They come in, and he know I was sad. And he was like, he told me to look up the book. He was like, what was the place that you wanted to get your breast done again? And I was just irked because, like, I'm in pain and he's just asking me fucking questions and shit. You know, I was having one of them things. Yeah, I wasn't having it. So, and I'm just like, why? And I'm all in the middle of the motherfucking, right before they about to put the silicone in the motherfucking. So I'm all into the video and shit. And he come in, he was like, let me see. He was like, just call him up. I just want to get some information. And I'm just like, in my head, I'm thinking like, information on what? Like, whatever you want to know about it, just ask me. I know this shit. Like, what the fuck? In my head, I ain't even gonna lie. In my head, like, he about to buy this shit. Like, what the fuck? So, yeah. I call the place up. I act like I ain't know shit. Inquiring some information about some titties and a boob job. And I'm asking them all the questions and shit. We had it on speakerphone. And then she was like, would you like to set up a consultation? A free consultation or whatever? And he snatches the phone from me. No, I was just calling just to get some information about it. She was like, oh, okay. But then he snatched the phone and was like, hold on. Yes, how do you, what you say, babe? What did you say? Something about, what you ask him? Oh, how long do you have to? Yeah.
How long after you have a miscarriage can you get an operation done?
Yeah. How long after you have a miscarriage can you get your breast done? And it was like 6 to 8 weeks. You have to wait until your I forget what is it, ACGs or something, levels go down.
Probably.
And he was like, oh, okay. So I see him like looking in the calendar or whatever, and he was like, well, he would like to schedule basically he scheduled the appointment. And long story fucking short, he scheduled that shit, paid for that shit in full. The fuck, like my balls just I swear to God, my fucking balls dropped, son. So I couldn't even believe it. No, real shit. Like my pussy slid down my fucking leg. Like I could not even believe that shit. It just dropped, splat, right on the fucking floor, wet as shit. It's like, but anyway, I couldn't even believe it. And then he kissed me on my forehead, and then he went outside, blew an L. And he came back. I could not, like, honestly, if that was not the happiest, second happiest day of my life, because the first happiest day was Zaysha. Seriously, I was stunned. And honestly, I still really couldn't believe it all the way up until we got to Miami. Like, yo, remember we was on a plane and then we get there and I'm like, yo, this shit is really happening. Yeah. This shit is really happening. I'm really about to get a boob job. Like, yo, this shit is crazy. So that's the history behind it. Fucking, the reason why we went to Miami is because they're way cheaper. Philadelphia, highest shit. They charge like fucking $10,000 for a boob job. The fuck? That shit better take me to work. But yeah, that's too high. I'm not paying $10,000 for a boob job, especially when in Miami that shit is like the regular price is $5,000, but they had a special going on, so they did have the credit, because at first he paid $5,000 for him, but then we look on the website and they was having from this date to that date, they was, if you get silicone, that they was dropping the price to $3,000 or $3,500, whatever. But altogether, we paid like $32 something.
Yeah. Taxes and stuff.
Yeah. So that's why we decided to go to Miami. Plus, it was fun as shit going to Miami. Yep. And from Philly to Miami is only like 2.5 hours. Yeah, so that was sweet.
It was a good flight.
It was a good flight, definitely. The place I stayed at was called Downtown Hollywood Boutique. It was nice as shit.
Nice.
I uploaded a video.
It was like a little villa.
Yes. I uploaded a video on my YouTube. It's like the first video. It was nice. It's basically an apartment. So it has the bedroom, bathroom, the living room, and a full kitchen, dining room. Oh yeah, it had a little back, little deck and everything. It was nice. Our own private pool that heated up or some shit, right?
No, yeah, the pool out front.
Yeah, that joint was nice. That's because we was there from Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and I didn't want to be stuck in a room.
And it was better.
Sore as shit for 5 days in one little room.
Surgery is more comfortable.
Yeah, and it was more comfortable, so. Bang, man. yeah, so it was really nice. But, alright, so let's get to this fucking pre-op.
Pre-op.
Nigga.
That was the worst part, man. What time we had to be there? Like,
yo,
11,
my
right?
Appointment was 11 o'clock.
It was a little late, you know.
We was fashionably.
A little on nigga time, but.
Yeah, we was definitely on nigga time. But. We was fashionably late. Yo, when we got there like 11:30, whatever, 45, maybe 12. But I called them and I told them that we was running late. That was because we was trying to get our rental together.
Yeah, you know how the bank, you gotta let them know you traveling and all
that.
Yeah,
we forgot to put the travel notice to the bank
and all
that.
Protecting my account from any fraud.
so we had to deal with that bullshit.
We just had to make a phone call.
So we get there fashionably late. They was like, oh, the wait time. Basically, my name ain't even come up yet. Anyway, the wait time, I just had to sign my name on the paper. The wait time was an hour and a half, 2 hours tops. They was like, oh, go out and get yourself something to eat or something. So we went out to the place called Osio. If y'all ever in Miami and y'all love Colombian food.
Venezuelan fusion. Good food.
Definitely. What was it? Colombian,
Italian, and Venezuelan food.
Yeah.
All them types of food at that store.
That shit was fucking good. We was going to go to Benihana's, but they was packed. Yeah, the wait was too long, and we seen this other place, and I'm like, ooh, I want some. What did it say on the door? OCO Fusion or some shit. Colombian Fusion. So we went there. It was nice as shit. The food was too good. They had some shit called coconut lemonade.
That was good.
Oh my god, that shit tastes like sex in a motherfucking cup. That shit tastes so good. I love coconut and I love lemonade. But anywho, so I went and have 2 hours. They said they wrote my number down and told me they was gonna call me when my name come up. I'm like, all right, cool. 2 hours came. I'm like, damn, these motherfuckers didn't call me. Let's head back just in case they forgot or whatever, and they put somebody in front of me. We go back.
It was crowded in there too.
It was so fucking crowded in there. I'm like, damn, everybody want fake titties. Like, fuck out of here.
most of the people in there was getting butt
done. But mostly everybody in there, they was getting like they butt done. And
that lipo shit.
Oh, yeah, and that lipo stuff. I'm like, what the fuck? Go the fuck home. Like, it's my turn. Like, but. Yeah, that shit was crowded. Long story short, my fucking appointment was at 11 o'clock. The place closed at 7. I didn't get seen until 8 o'clock at night. That fucked up our whole day, son. Our whole fucking day. Like, that shit was crazy. So, I couldn't even see because that was the day that I was really supposed to see. Because even the doctor left. I was supposed to see the doctor and tell him what and pick my size and everything. But I ain't do that until the next day or whatever. So even with the prescription, remember? They were supposed to give me the prescription the day before. And I was supposed to bring it back the next day. Because the next day, it's like the Monday was the pre-op. Tuesday was the day of the surgery, and Wednesday was the post-op. Oh, whatever. Yeah, that shit was crazy. But whatever. That shit was long. So the next day I came in, and we did all that there. I wasn't really in there that long. Was I?
The surgery part?
Yeah.
No, you was
out. Yeah, the wait was sweet.
He said that it was a 2-hour process. The surgery took 45 minutes.
The surgery only took 45 minutes.
And then the anesthesia take an hour to wear off for you to wake up and all that.
Yeah. And they gave me these. Yeah. And they gave me the two, what's that stuff called? Oh, the prescriptions they give you is, they give you a muscle relaxer.
Antibiotic.
And
some Percocets.
And some shit for nausea. Me personally, I don't like pills. I don't like nothing that can make me drowsy or high. Yeah. You know, it's like I'll drink to get like on, and maybe if I'm around my man, I'll drink to get drunk. So you know what I'm saying, but. But other than that, I don't like nothing to have any, like, control. Like, I don't like to be like this. Like, I don't like that shit. And that shit had me fucked up. And usually I don't ever take medicine for nothing. Like, no Tylenol. Yeah,
he literally... She got cold. I got to fight with her.
Like, literally, he literally have to fight with me. And not fight with me to give me the medicine. Even after he's finished fighting with me, I'm still not taking the medicine. Like, I literally don't take Nothing for nothing. I didn't take the medicine they gave me for my miscarriage. I ain't take the medicine they gave me for my when I had a baby. I don't take medicine for nothing. I remember back in like 2010, I had pneumonia. I ain't take the medicine for that. Like, I never take nothing for nothing. I'm one of them annoying people that think everything can go away natural.
But I think the doctor after the surgery, he did a real good job.
Yeah, he definitely did
a good job.
He knew
what was going to fit your body right. And,
Yeah.
Fit your body right.
So this is a full C cup. What about the And as you've seen in my previous video, I ain't have no breasts. I ain't no titties. I was in the fucking negatives. These bitches is beautiful. Yes, they are a little
swollen
right now. So they are going to go down. But right now, these bitches is beautiful. Hold on, let's check. Ain't they perfect? They love him. He's so obsessed. He like, I know you only had him for a couple days, but I forgot what you look like without him. These bitches is beautiful. And I just feel like if you want your breasts done, get them done. But get them done for you. Like, seriously. Do not get them done for... no other reason, not because somebody else want him done. Because for a long time, I've been messing with him for a long fucking time. He was my very first boyfriend when I was 12 years old. Like, listen, he's heard me say over and over years, that I've always wanted breasts. And he will always say, no matter how flat my chest was, even though we was twinning in a bed, like really twinning. he will always be like, no, you don't need them. I don't care. I want them. Not for you, but for myself. Breast is confidence. You know what I mean? It's not like I'm getting my ass done or something. Like, I really, it's very uncomfortable.
If it makes you feel better, make you happy.
Right. Aww.
I'm happy. Feel me?
Right. And breast, this is what really made me happy. Like, I really love breasts. I always just wanted them. Just to make myself feel comfortable. And at the end of the day, these bitches is fake. And I really don't care. Because at the end of the day, I was fraud. Right. And at the end of the day, I was frauding anyway. I'm going to keep it real. I was frauding anyway. Yes. Yo.
It's the same shit.
Real shit. Yo, listen. My fucking bras, mind you, I was a fucking negative ace. I can still wear training bra. My bra sizes was like B cups. Why the fuck am I wearing a B cup bra? Sometimes motherfucking C cup, just so you can see something in my shirt. And that shit was super duper padded. Like, that shit ain't, what is it called? Victoria's Secret bombshells.
Yeah.
I was frauding anyway in these streets. I was. So, and all that fucking wire and shit, nah, I'm done. Especially when you, it's one thing for a bra to hurt because you have breasts. Or whatever, and they're just annoying to wear. But, you know, at least you have to wear. But listen, when you don't have breasts, why the fuck is my bra hurting? Like, why am I dealing with titty problems when I ain't even got no fucking titties? My nigga, that was annoying. So, yes. But,
you know, then
I feel more grown. I feel more my age. Before, I felt like a little ass girl. And then every shirt or sexy dress just never looked like. And I used to always have to put them, what's them thing? Remember them little, you know them little gel, silicone gel things to push it together just so I could get some cleavage and some breasts so I could look like a fucking woman. Yeah, man. That shit was a struggle. For real, because I like to be cute. I like to, even, like, this is one of my little sexy lingeries that I would wear for bae. But you see how, you know, clearly this was an A cup thing. I'm going to have to get another one. I just put it on for the video. Yeah, but this was, like, an extra, extra small, because, of course, I'm small. And my breasts would not even look right in it. Like, this part would be so soggy on me.
Yeah, because that part was weird.
Yeah, that shit was so loose and it was so embarrassing. I used to get so sad, like, I ain't even sexy.
Yeah, you still was sexy. In him, but...
he still bust my ass, but, it was like, he ain't care. No nibble, stretch mark nibble. But yeah, but right now they feel.
What they doing the post op?
Oh yeah, the post op.
They just checked it out, make sure it wasn't.
Yeah, they took my bandages off. Sorry.
Just try to keep up. This place.
See, he got my bag. He like, what about the post up? The post up. They took my bandages off, make sure everything was all right. They told me that I could wash up, and the tape is gonna fall off by itself, and to just cut the stitches. Only had 4 stitches. The stitches. The stitches as close to the skin as possible. And when I came home, no, seriously, that shit. I think I took drugs.
The first day, but the day after.
No, I was still sore as shit, remember?
Oh, the day after you were sore, but we still end up.
Yeah,
like, it ain't like you can't function at all.
Yeah, you can still function. You just gonna be in a lot of fucking pain.
Yeah, cause you going to the South.
And then I took those fucking medicines. Even though only took them drones for like 2 days. The first day I took them because they just popped them drones in my mouth. Those perks and everything. And then the second day, I think they gave me a half of one there in the day and a half of one at night. But then even when I was waking up, when I wasn't even on the purse, I was still fucking high. I was high as shit. I don't like
that. That's all the medicines make you drowsy.
Yeah, come to find out, all the medicines make me.
Muscle relaxer and the perks.
Yeah, I stopped taking the fucking perks because I ain't like being high. And I'm like, yo, and I was still taking a, what is it?
Muscle relaxer
and the antibiotics. And I was still high as shit. I'm like, yo, what the fuck? Is it the anesthesia or them fucking Percocets? Why am I still high? I look at the fucking bottle, my nigga. And then I'm like dizzy and shit. I look at the fucking bottle and come to find out the muscle relaxer and the fucking antibiotics may cause drowsiness, may cause dizziness. What the fuck? I stopped taking all that shit. Well, the only thing that I am still taking is the antibiotic. But I'm not taking no muscle relaxer. I'm just going... I'm just free bowling. Or what is it called? What's the slang word?
That's not the word, but you just taking anybody out. You
know, he's talking about that's not a word.
But we end up still going to South Beach.
But we went up. Oh, listen, we went to South Beach. That shit was nice. It was really nice. I wish I wasn't so sore. Yes, those coconuts were so nice.
Just had a relaxing time.
The guy that we rented the hotel from, he brought us fresh coconuts and fruits. Y'all gonna see the video that I posted. Fresh coconuts and exotic fruits and stuff in a big, nice munchy basket. That shit was nice. Then we went to fucking... the fucking sugar factory. I always wanted to go here. They took me here because I always wanted to go. Can I go to the sugar factory? I'm going to go to the sugar factory. Finally, he takes me. I will never go again. Thank you, though. I really appreciate you taking me. But what the fuck? The drinks is $42, which isn't an issue. Don't get us wrong. That's not the issue. But what the fuck? If my drink is $42, the drink is like this big, and it come in a... Like one of them goblet.
Yeah, it got a nice cups. It was nice with.
Yeah, it's nice and big.
So much damn ice.
But the fucking ice. All right, so this is how big it is. Ice filled up to here. This much. This is how big it is. This is how much ice is filled up. Along with a bunch of gummy bears and fucking shit that we ain't even gonna fucking eat. Because that shit is too sweet. And then you got this little ass bit of liquor. The fuck? No, it wasn't worth it. And then the menus was regular, plain Jane, fucking burgers.
We ate
burgers.
They can step that shit up a little bit.
Yeah, they need to step that shit up and improve that menu.
Yeah.
And they need to put that fucking ice shit on the side. Next time I go, I'm be like, I don't want no ice or no gummy bears. The kit.
Oh, liquor.
Right? The fuck? Like, shit, can I get my gummy bears on the side, please? The fuck? Where's the liquor at? But
was
I wasn't supposed to be drinking anyway. Yeah, overall, it was a good experience.
You went good and you said
everything definitely went well. My doctor name was Dr. Freiman from Coral Gables Cosmetics. It was nice. I told them I wanted the 4C. I got high profile, even though that's because I'm thin. That's what they recommend smaller people to get anyway. Nice and round, high profile. These joints is popping. And they don't hurt. Like, look, they don't hurt.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Like, nothing about them hurt. They feel good. And I still have the sensation in my nipples.
And they put yours under the muscle, right?
Yep. Oh, and it's under the muscle. My scar is like this big. It'll go away. And that's it.
Then they say you can still breastfeed with them?
Oh, yeah, and I can still, yeah, if I get pregnant again, I can still breastfeed. But my overall experience was amazing. I do recommend, you just have to have a lot of patience on that first day.
Yeah.
Or if we were smart, we should have just fucking just left again.
Yeah, right.
The fuck?
But they probably would have pushed us all the way back.
Yeah.
But overall, you did a good job.
Nice.
Good experience.
But even though they took long on the first day, but I guess it wasn't their fault because it was a lot of people in there. But the staff and everybody, they was nice. Ain't nobody had no attitude or anything. Everybody was nice. So
if you like this video,
like
it and subscribe.
And share.
And share too.
Share my experience. Any questions?
Comment
below.
Mm-hmm.
I'll take positive and negative comments. If you put a negative comment, I'm gonna fuck you up. It's like I'm playing. No, but seriously, I do. I take it all. But like, share, subscribe, please.
Thanks all you people for your
support. And thank you so much for the support from my Facebook fans, my Instagram. Like, I really, really appreciate y'all. My family, my friends, I do. I appreciate y'all. Y'all was amazing. I was. He's talking about, what about me, nigga? None of this would even be possible if it wasn't for you. I love you and I appreciate you. So, alright, we out. We gotta go to the fucking grocery store. Get some shit, cook some shit, eat some shit. Alright, see y'all. Bye.